Richardson. changes in this game. He's had two fallen players in both occasions, running each and every which way, and just managed to get it to avoid both players and pop over the sideline. If you want field position, that is a great way to get it.
Yeah, that's right. His forwards will thank him immensely for that. Austin will feed the scrum for Barcaldine, but that's where they want to play the game, in Barcaldine's half, do black ball. They feed the scrum. Doug Gish very unhappy with that. Right down the far end of the ground now. Austin looking, probing for the ball. Looks like he's come away with it as a wake of the scrum there. He'll play it 10 metres short. 10 metres off their own line, I should say. Peter White has a run out of dummy half. Supporting one of those very nude haircuts, should we say. Wilson now gets it away. The pass out the back door, can't pick up the number. Mark Gordon fell on the attack though, 20 metres out from their own line. Played the ball back. Wilson shows it inside, goes outside to Matthews. Good metres gain there from Matthews. He's about 10 metres short of halfway. Right on the far side of the ground now. Goes away to Kerrigan. Kerrigan puts the head down. Five tackles gone. 5 metres short of halfway. Kerrigan looking for a penalty on the last tackle. Doesn't get it. Peter White. He gets the kick in. Looks like it's been touched by Michael. Charge down. Mark Gordon coming in. Doug Gish, what's he going to rule here? 47 knock-ons. They'll pick a scrum down. 10 metres inside.
Barkey got the feed, I think.
Barkey looked like getting the loose head and feed. Al Kavanagh is saying what we're talking about before, but sir.
Yes.
And he's not going to get it anyway. Brad Horton will feed the scrum 10 metres short of halfway. About 20 in on the western side of the ground. Goes to Wilson now. He offloads to Kempson. Kempson, he's caught. Will be 5 metres short of halfway. Wilson offloads again. Good ball to Kerrigan it was. Must be just on halfway now. Mark Gordon still in position. Darts at a dummy half. Good work from the hooker. Kevin Barry it was. Gets inside Blackhall territory. First time they've been there since they scored the try, Mark Gordon. They're deep now. Goes to Wilson. Wilson on the Matthews again. In plenty of space. Ross Matthews gets the ball.
Yeah.
All he did was cop up possession. Did he know he did up? He did up. starts out now. He asks himself, Richardson, good yards from him. Paul Arthur wraps him up. Point in the ground.
Good evening to folk listening to our coverage of the game tonight at the Prince of Wales Hotel in Blackpool.
Yes, mate. Great supporters of the rugby league. Cool. Are they having a cold one? Great place to be, too, on a Saturday evening, Mick.
Couldn't think of a better thing to be doing, having a cold evening listening to the football.
That's
for us.
That's right.
Blackpool's well and truly in position. Nice bust there from number four.
Simpson at one. He gets almost to the halfway line. Kapner in an acting half, gets it away to Harlow. Harlow with the kick, looking for touch again. Over the head of the winger, he's found it again.
He's definitely got a pity shot to every blade of grass on this paddock work now. Three times he's done that.
He's had a few games here. Tim Harlow at the Bark Alton Showground. Finding touch again. Over the head of Mick Hanson it was. Great kick.
You wouldn't be looking for number seven to score here, Robert.
No, not at all.
No.
Go Cav. You can do it. Go son. Look at the ground will truly He's coming up over the tree.
It's going to be fiery when it gets over.
It looks sensational. That's why we live here. The great scenery and blue water. It's so cool. That's what they do anyway. They've got the most man, unfortunately. Unbelievable, he has a look at his hands, he can't believe it. I don't think the other 12 of his teammates can either. They've coughed up possession 30 metres out from their own line. Barkle made the loose head and feed with an opportunity to strike straight back. As I said, 22 minutes gone in the first half. 10 points to 4 in favour of the Sanguiners. Orson takes it out now. He goes to Marty Borson on there. Borson gets it away. Peter White. He'll play it 35 metres out from the line. Barkle now on the attack. I think it's Wilson, is it? He plays it down to Horston anyway. He's trying to pull up. And Harvick, three tackles, a bootleg to see. Down there, Turner. That's the lead out of Aliana. On the attack now, Victor Jenkins. He's having it on the ground, 11 metres off the line. Imara was the tackler. Plays it back, goes to Horston. Horston got runners on both sides of him. Gives it to Horston on the inside, 5 metres off the line.
Down 10 metres short of halfway, so Blake will have the lead.
anyone coming to meet the Spirit of the Outback tonight, you'd be advised that it's just coming into the show corner station now. So it'll be about an hour after getting it on. We're normally there about 7. It'll be about 8:30 before the Spirit gets in. Blackall back in possession and really making some yards now right up the middle, which is the only way to do it.
That's right, Mick. 30 metres out from the line now. Richardson in a dummy half. Goes to Kavner. They're on to Harlow. Harlow gets it away to Simpson. Simpson steps, comes back inside, trucks out of one, gets the ball away on the run to Harlow. Harlow gets it out to Smith. Clayton Smith, he comes back inside. Still going. 10 metres short of the line now. Blackall on the attack. Trying to hit back with another try. It's Ren Noonan. Noonan. He's caught by Ross Matthews. They just got the mail where Ross Matthews shaved his head. Makes him a little bit quicker over 100 metres, they reckon. That's what it is.
He's probably knew that 35 metres before.
Because he actually did a pretty easy journey. A kick from Harlow into the end goal. Good chase, though. It's been cleaned up there by Mark Holden.
Managing to smother it, otherwise it was going to be dry for them.
McHanson cleaned it up, but they've trapped him on the end goal. Good chase by the winger from Blackall. Trevor Barton, I think it was. He's caught him in the end goal. So Blackall will have another set of six. Speaking about doing the simple things right, Nelly. 16 points to 4 on the Coca-Cola scoreboard in favour of Mark Alden, but both sides getting through their sets of six pretty well on the end of a good kick and chase. Kick back now, picked up by David Clark for Blackall. Good drop out over the halfway line, and just getting into Mark Alden territory. And a dummy half in the middle. Off the interchange bench, Richardson and a dummy half goes to Noonan. Noonan finds Clayton Smith, the fullback, almost out of one tackle. But the other three that come over the top leave the ground. 30 metres out from the line now, Richardson to Noonan. Noonan cuts out Kavner, finds Harlow. Harlow cuts out Simpson, finds the winger in Austin, tries to stand his opposite number up, get the ball back inside. Still going, Blackall. Right on the far side of the field now, very hard to pick up the players. Goes to Harlow once more. Back to Kavner. Kavner dummies, goes inside. Kavner pops the pass back to Harlow on the runaround. Harlow gets out of one tackle, still going, Tim Harlow. The attention comes for him now.
Good work.
rugby player. Couldn't handle it, Simpson. He was away, shot the gate, no doubt about it. 16 points to 12, that would have made it.
Yeah, tell you what, the guys will be getting moonstruck out there. Have a go that she's coming up as you predicted it would.
Oh, mate, beautiful. Moonstruck, that probably would be wide, one point.
Plenty of defenders there to make sure it did go out.
Good work, though, from Barkle. There was another good set of six. Both sides, as I said, have been putting in. They set the six very well. Blackhawk will get a good penalty here. Bad mistake. It was Barry, I think. They've affected a good tackle on Richardson. And then as they got up, they just grabbed his foot, give away another six tackles. I suppose if you're going to make a mistake, make it on the first tackle. Harlow now, off the tap. Give away back on the inside ball. David Clark, it was almost the halfway. He'll get up and play it. Back to Richardson. Go to the open side with Noonan. Ball up and race out of the line. Missing. Comes back inside to Clark again. Clark, he's flung to the ground. Good tackle. With Matthew. Goes on to Cavanagh now. Cavanagh to Harlow. Harlow gets a cutout ball and no one except him to touch. Both supporting players went without it. So the Blackhawk back line just failing to gel at this point in time. Vic, they get things right, it would be a very interesting ball game.
Certainly would, and there's still plenty of time to go. We're coming up to the end of this particular half, and there's still another 40 minutes of play remaining. Right, if you can't think of an excuse to go fishing, what about dropping down to the Union Hotel in Blackhawk?
Mate, I tell you what, as far as fishing goes, I really don't know what end of the bait goes on and which part you actually throw in the water. But I have been known to up the top of the old stubby on this. I think the Union's the go. We can take the fishing.
Back into the ball game now, Marky back in possession and looking pretty strong too, but beautiful tag there from both sides. That was a copy ball by the Canterbury on the boot places from Blackhawk.
Yeah, see, yep, the defence on both sides has been pretty much above par, mate. With the fullback from Blackhawk, that's been called right around the boot places on Paul Arthur, who's been doing all of the copy ball tackling tonight. And I think Matthews, one of the first times they've contained Ross Matthews tonight. Tim Harlow was there, pulled him up 10 metres inside Golden Territory. Laurel Wollaton had a bit of a look went without it. He's coughed up possession. Blackhawk come away with it. Through the hand of Avery. 10 metres short of halfway. Now to Gary Vickery on off the bench for Blackhawk. He makes a few yards. They get it back to Chapman. Another interchange feature player for the Blackhawk side tonight. Plays it back to Richardson under Kavanagh. Goes inside to Noonan it was. No hole. In the centre of the rough there for Bart Holden. Wrapped up by Wayne Osborne, it was. Good tackle from him. Marnie Borson was there as well. Harlow looking for touch, doesn't find it this time. Straight down the wing, it's through. Well, he's using for that. 1 out of 4 is not bad, Vic.
Yeah, he's been good on the move.
20 metres out from their own line now. Good positional play there from Harlow. Both sides have used their territory very well. Bart Holden on the attack. Working it away from their own line, 20 metres out.
Got a ball to do that into the field, a long way to go, and Blackhawk very quickly up on the every time they play the ball.
About 25 out now, Borson plays it back, they go wide, can't pick up the player's number, but they're still only about 25 metres out from their own line. Borson had another run straight and hard, goes long. Borson brushes out of one tackle, a second and third come, they put him to ground probably 11 metres short of halfway, still in their own territory though. Mark Allen goes back to the fullback, Peter White for the kick. Only looking kick, it's got plenty of metres on it though. Gets within inside the 20. Clayton Smith cleaned it up. For the Blackhawk side, steps the first defender. Just to away from Wilson, it was. Leroy Wilson, Paul Arthur, put in the ground, and Richardson has a run in a dummy half. Arthur claims him as well. 15 metres short of halfway. Barkle in the ball offside there. Doug gets refereeing from the centre of the ruck. He can't be in two places at once. Good plan. Michael, he plays back down. Goes to Chapman and he's looking for the halfway line. He's not going to find it though. They drive him back. 10 metres or so. He's still 11 metres short of halfway now. Goes to Noonan. Noonan inside the ball of halfway. But in the fence though, they're in the centre of the ruck. Five tackles gone. They play back to Richardson. They'll go back to Noonan for the kick. He looks for the touchline. It's a good looking kick there on the far side of the ground. Running, searching for the touchline. He finds it. Good kicking game from both sides. That was Jesse Noonan, the 5'8". Harlow, their normal kicker, he was caught on the fourth tackle with it. Good kick over the head of the winger. Plenty of ground, 20 metres out from the far Gordon line. A scrum will pack down. Far Gordon loose head and feet. Players walking a little bit slowly there. Scrum only about a minute and a half before half time.
Score then of 16-8 in favour of Barkey with Blackhall. They're just starting to pack the scrum down now, so they're using up plenty of time on the clock. We may not see too much more in this particular half of the ball game. Ball goes in, comes out Barkey's way.
The feed the scrum, comes out now. Trying to use the McCracken. He plays it back 20 metres out. Off his own line now. Ball comes there. Gets it away. And he ends up with Barton. Little bit of the way in that tackle. Guess let's just keep him down. Trevor Barton it was. Tackle for Michael. Mark Alden now in position, 10 metres short of halfway. Goes to Kerrigan. Kerrigan straightens the attack. They pick him up and drive him into the ground. Avery, it was underneath. Harlow over the belt. Heard the big fella, but he knew all about it. Low balls and they smash him into the ground. He got a good ball away though. On the far side of the field, the Logan Kelly. Five tackles gone, still a little bit short of halfway, Mark Alden. He'll go back to White for the kick. Plenty of pressure and chases there. Sort of bad-looking kick either, looking for the touchline. He's got a B-grade bounce. He's gone back inside. Smith, there's plenty of chases there in the form of Leroy Wilson. He gets away from Wilson. Gets away from Forster as well. Wilson comes again and he claims him 21 metres out from the Blackhall line. Richardson out of dummy half. Good chase again from Wilson to Marga. Smith, he has his second run. He smashed the ground. Carried it. Kelly over the top. The half-time hooter sounds on the background. Scrum, 20 metres out, only about 10 from touch on the Longridge side of the ground. Forster comes Good run from the white ball fullback. Interesting statistic at half time in the black ball camp. Their fullback claims to miss the guy, Sneakoff, was leading the tackles and the hit ups, which is not really a good statistic for a fullback to be leading, but he's been up in the line a fair bit, though. Think he has gone through a power of work, and the kick chase game from Black Ball has been good, so he's had a lot of returning to do.
Thank you. A little while ago.
Gordon from that tap. They're 20 metres out from the black hole line on the attack. Morrison goes to Wilson. Wilson goes to line, gives it to Kempton. Kempton on to McCracken. McCracken, they've got an overlap here. They go back inside. Kempton's got one down and he eventually turns up top back to the referee. Not yet. Beautiful. He'll play back down. Out of the half. That's Borsa. That's Marnie Borsa. He'll play back to Barry. 10 metres out from the line now. Mark Gordon on the attack. Horston. Dummy goes back inside himself, gets a kick in, over the top, there's Tracer there, it's going to be too deep, he'll come back to the 20 metre line for the tap restart. I thought that was a little bit of a bad option there from Grant Horton, he had players deep, it worked so well, Matthew's out wide, he busted him two or three times on the fringes of the ruck. Been an absolute handful for the Blackhawks centres. Ross Matthews running at pace, getting a good ball away and so on, scored a try in the first half. He went back inside with the kick. There was no chase. There was a little bit too much weight on the kick. Now Harley. Almost out on one tackle. Tim Harley. Got 10 metres short of halfway. 20 from touch. The long reach side of the ground. Goes to Kavanagh. Kavanagh on the run around. Does a pick up. Noonan dummies to him. Still a couple of metres short of halfway. Blackall on the attack. Now. Kavanagh got a ball away. And Turner it was. Halfway.
Pick up the trumpet.
Juggled. Oh, I think Blackwood do the draw, mate. I don't think
Thank you.
Carlos Gorman in favour of the mark. All the Sango and his ballers are now in the pass on to Graham Brown. He pulled out 10 metres for a half play. Play back to Kevin Parry. They go wide right now to get to eggs there. Jenkins. And Jenkins gets to the halfway line. Good run from the front row. They've got a back left set deep here, Mark Owen. Go to Marnie Bullison. They get it away. Trying to handle Wilson now. Wilson, they cut out. Got a hand to it. McGregor ends up with it in the end. He's flung the ground by Richardson. A little push me from Logan Kelly there. Going back to Matthews. He strains the attack. Good run from Ross Matthews. Gets out a 1-2 tackle. Still going Matthews. The support was on the left. He looked to the right. Was there Wayne Osborne was there. Gets it back to Paul Arthur now. He put the kick in. Cleaned up swing. Knocked on down there by Trevor Barton. Bad mistake from the winger for Blackall. Kicked it straight down his throat. He's knocked on. So 20 metres out from the Blackall line. Bark Alden looks scrambled. Got out. Bark Alden will have the loose at the seas.
Got a little bit of noise coming through there. If you could just drop that one down a bit, it'd be a real help. Okay, Brian, well, we've got about, 12 or 13 minutes to go in this game, and Barkey getting that last one certainly made all the difference and putting those extra 6 points on, and the difference of being 24-14 in favour of the San Joannas as they come away from another scrum win. Look at them penetrate the defence.
Yeah, Osborne stepped out of two or three there. They finally put him to the ground, only about 10 metres out now. Barkley, they can put this game away here. 10 points of deficit at the moment. Wilson now, dummies the low ball that goes to McCracken. McCracken gets away from one, can't get away from the second tackler. They put him to the ground, about 10 metres out. Deep, they go to Wilson. Wilson to Paul Arthur, stepping both ways. Can't penetrate the line though. Five out, Barkley is still on the attack. And about four tackles still up there, please. Slowest play of the ball in Australia. Finally goes to Wilson. Wilson, a cut-out ball. It was around the length of Matthews. That was going to be the other try time again for Barkley. The old set move. Wilson, give it straight to Ross Matthews and he'll just score. Anyway, Blackall will come up with it from that mistake. Pass around the ankles of Matthews. He couldn't take it. He would have scored if he had. 20 metres short of halfway, Blackall still on the attack with Kavner now. Kavner goes to Harlow. Harlow drawing a couple of it. Defenders getting a ball away in the end. Finally picked up. Dwayne Tooman is the centre. It's going to be on here in a minute. There's 20 yards and that tackle everywhere. Took it to McCracken. Still can't put into ground. 20 metres short.
Time to call Hamilton.
Up the line, yeah, you would imagine so. A chip put in by Harlow. Straight down the throat of Leroy Wilson. There's been a knock on there somewhere. Arthur picking up the scramble back down right on halfway. About 25 metres in from the grandstand side. Touchline, knock on from Mark Allen. Wilson must have knocked it on from the kick. Kavner will feed the scrum, as I said, right on halfway. The scrum finally comes out. Kavner takes it out. Tries to get away from Marnie Balls and can't do so. And even Dan Kempton trying to win the ground, still can't do it. Playing it all out. Get a dummy half. Boy, shot there. Referee don't get it. Okay, cool. It's going to be a penalty to Blackall. So it should have been two. They're
No, it's Kempo.
He's fucking taking for a ride, mate. It was Dick Martin.
Congratulate you on the win. You had to tougher out a bit at the finish. You made it pretty hard on yourselves. There's a lot of things that's wrong out there tonight that we're going to work on next week.
The stuff we do is just basic football. It's fucking basic. Kids can do it.
But we're not even doing it. We're not even sticking to that.
And that's right.
Everyone knows, like forwards, we know that fame. It's easy to nominate three rucks in advance.
Christ.
And you've all got to do it. Me included. I had a shocker. I don't want to keep going, but that's it. But apart from that, we've done big,
Do we have good sets there when the forwards, like Rowney, was making some great runs? Moose was hitting her up. You just had a lot more time, didn't you?
Sorry?
The backs had more time when we were taking the ball up.
No. Well, I think a lot was up, fucking. Blackwell was getting up way too fucking quick, too, off the 10. I don't think Geshi was getting a good 10. I don't think he was way too early on us as well. I mean, so I was getting the ball sometimes and the fucking whole side was up there. I mean, I don't care how deep out of the if you're standing on the dumb enough, you still shouldn't have the fucking whole team up in place. But standing in your pockets.
I watched the video, but I think another area where we were really, really slow in the night was our plate balls. That's why they were getting up early. They were stuffing around their play the balls, but we weren't really fighting it up.
But that was their intention, I think.
Yeah, really slow. Well, they know Geshi's not going to. But we've got a really, you can use your old ways, do whatever you like. You want to start, don't start holding me in, you've got to fight to get up. I think Jacko down at once, Timmy, and he's about to go.
Hello.
We've got to take the same attitude as what Jacko done. No matter who we're playing against, fight to get up and play the ball. All we're doing is giving them free shots on the likes of Brad and Leroy and our back line. There's a couple of things that were said from Pete didn't say much, but he didn't know. Tonight we were moving up and we weren't sliding. Once the ball passed us, we weren't looking after the blokes on the outside. We thought our job was done. Daniel, do you see that?
Yeah.
Others have played
that right. That was the first half, that right side. Them was the centres then. There was me and Kempo out there, and like we kick off down to this side of the field, and they'd have their one ruck and come out of their way, and then it was just me and Dan out there.
Just a bit too slow. Once they come like from the kickoff, everyone runs up into that corner and chases the ball, and then instead of changing to a cross, that's when they get me fucking on that right side.
But that's basic shit too. You don't, when we kick off, everyone doesn't have to follow the frigging ball. Yeah. You should just go straight. That's fucking kid stuff.
Yeah. And you got your line.
Just go straight. The bloke who's in front of the bloke who catches the ball fucking tackles him.
Well,
leave
it till Tuesday night, Thursday night, we'll work on it. I'll watch the video. Let's start putting in the effort for next week. Who won't be there at training Tuesday? Boss, Aaron.
The other people?
The blokes on Ago and Rowdy and Blake. That's fair enough, fellas. Well, yeah, I hope you have a good night. Kate, you want to say a few words or half?
Now
it's on over
you. I
wouldn't be a good
brother.
We still don't know what we're playing next week.
I heard Kev Jackson told me that Longmans were looking at playing it on Sunday. I don't know for sure.
I can't complain. It's in the first thing in the morning. Races in the morning, so.
Not really.
Malcolm, who got me a match?
You want me to make the match?
Hey, before Malcolm does the players play, how about three cheers for our strappers and runners, mate?
Hip, hooray! Hip, hooray! Hip, hooray!
Yeah, I'm player
with
Moose anyway.
Well done. Give yourself a beer, Moose.
And I'll have rum instead of beer.
Good, I'll mix you up.
Well, don't forget we got...